You know that feeling when you're mid-code, coffee in hand, and then your phone pings. New email, subject line. Important changes to your Claude subscription. It's not panic exactly, but you know, nothing good ever comes from an AI company with important changes in the subject line. And so I open it, take a breath, and yeah, it's what we've been waiting for, or maybe dreading a little. Claude's finally putting up the guardrails for real. Weekly rate limits, new quotas, a kind of reality check for anyone who's been riding hard on the Max or Opus plans, or honestly, anyone who built their workflow on the assumption that this magic box would be bottomless. I figured, let's talk through this together. What does it really mean, not just for Anthropic servers, but for us, the solo devs? The indie folks who live or die by these tools, who've made Claude a real daily thing in our work. I want to break down what's actually changing, how it's going to hit different plans, and most importantly, how should we feel about it? Is this good, bad, just inevitable, or maybe a little of all three? So, yeah, let's just settle in, no panic. No AI Twitter drama, just a real check-in on what this means for us, for Pro, Max, and Max Plus, and how to keep building, even when the rules change. Real quick, I'm Daniel. I've been in the iOS game for almost 8 years, freelancing and shipping apps for other people. But since DubDub25, I've gone full solo dev, started building in public, and yeah, kind of figuring out this personal brand thing as I go. More on that for another video. I want to start by zooming out because this isn't just about one email. For a lot of us, Claude code felt like a cheat code when it dropped, especially if you're a solo builder or you're the kind of person who's always trying out new frameworks on the weekends. It was so much power for the price. You could basically keep an AI pair programming assistant running all day, every day, planning features, rewriting Swift UI views, summarizing Firebase docs, helping with core data migrations, even just chatting about app ideas when your brain was fried and you needed an outside perspective. If you've been building apps, especially in Swift or Swift UI, you know how much friction a good AI tool can take away. It felt like having a senior engineer on call, but with none of the scheduling, no DMs, no Slack threads. Just you, your repo, and Claude. The value? Pretty much insane for the price. The pro plan at $20 a month was, honestly, the best bargain in AI for a while. Even when you pushed up into Max or Max Plus, it still felt generous, maybe a little magical. But let's be honest, in the back of our minds, there was always that sense that this couldn't last. GPU prices, cloud costs, that weird nagging voice that says, surely someone is running 10 Claude sessions 24/7, pasting in the entire Linux kernel and training custom models, and I'm subsidizing it. Maybe we thought that would happen next year, maybe next month. Today, it happened. So, the email. Let's actually talk through what they said and what they didn't. It's not a doomsday message. It's not we're shutting down. In fact, it's surprisingly calm for a message that's going to hit people right in the workflow. They open with the classic, we're introducing new weekly rate limits for Claude subscribers, affecting less than 5% of users based on current usage patterns, which is the corporate way of saying if you don't use Claude like a maniac, you're probably fine. But if you do, heads up. The first real detail is that starting August 28th, they're layering in new weekly usage limits in addition to the 5-hour rolling cap that's already in place. That means up until now, if you hit your usage wall, you just waited 5 hours, came back and picked up where you left off. It wasn't fun, but you always knew when the faucet turned back on. Now there's a weekly ceiling too. Hit it and you're done until next Monday. What gets me is the phrasing. Our new rate limits address these issues and provide a more equitable experience for all users. It's fair, but it's also a gentle way of saying, hey, this isn't just about abusers. It's about system capacity, fairness, and maybe finally getting this business sustainable. And let's be honest, when you see equitable experience for all users, what you really hear is, we saw people running Claude in the background 24/7. We saw reselling. We saw folks sharing accounts. It's not the hobbyist or the solo dev they're worried about. It's the folks who figured out the loopholes, and now everyone pays the price. Here's the nuts and bolts. Starting August 28th, it's not just the old 5-hour rolling usage cap. Now there's a hard weekly usage limit too. And it's not just you get X hours per week. It's more nuanced because there are different caps depending on your plan and your model. If you're using Sonnet 4, the bread and butter Claude model for most Pro and Max users, the numbers look like this. Most Max 5X users can expect 140 to 280 hours of Sonnet 4 and 15 to 35 hours of Opus 4 within their weekly rate limits. That sounds huge, and for a lot of us, it actually is. But the real story isn't the best case scenario. It's what happens if you have big code bases, or you're running multiple sessions in parallel, or you lean hard on Opus for the context window. And it's not just about time. Anthropic is also thinking about the way people use the product. If you're running Claude like a persistent background process, or you've built some kind of pipeline that pushes data in and out 24/7, you're going to hit those new ceilings a lot faster than someone who opens a session, asks for help, closes it, and gets back to coding. For the real power users, and you know who you are, this is going to feel like a clamp down. But for the rest of us, the email is kind of reassuring. They say most users won't notice any difference. The weekly limits are set high enough that normal project use, even for folks who build solo but build a lot, will keep humming along until you hit a wall. Let's talk through each plan, because this is where it gets real for solo devs. If you're on the basic pro tier, not much changes in the day-to-day. Your 5-hour reset is still there. And unless you're pushing huge files or keeping sessions alive all week, you'll probably be fine. But the ceiling is now there, and it's weekly, not just rolling. It's a subtle but real shift. If you ever found yourself bumping into the 5-hour wall and just waiting it out, now you might hit a point where waiting doesn't help. You're just done until the next cycle. Here's where things get more interesting. The max plan was always for folks who either needed more horsepower, think big code review sessions, or iterating over entire app folders, or running Claude like a local LLM that actually scales, or just wanted the peace of mind of priority access and higher limits. With the new changes, max users get a much larger weekly bucket, but it's still finite. If you're doing multiple big projects, or you're pairing Claude with Cursor or other tools and moving lots of data, you might still run into those new ceilings, especially at the end of a heavy week. This is for the true power users, the folks who treat Claude like their entire backend, their daily research partner, their continuous integration tool, their code reviewer and doc generator and idea machine. Max plus means more headroom, more capacity, more peace of mind, but it's also expensive. If you're a solo dev, this is the plan you look at when you realize your entire workflow is bottlenecked by AI rate limits, and you can justify the cost as a business expense. What's fascinating here is that even at the highest tier, the ceiling is now explicit. It's not infinite AI for a flat fee. It's a lot, but not limitless. And that feels like the new normal for everyone. So is this a good thing or a bad thing? That's honestly the question I keep coming back to. On one hand, I get it. The cost to run these models is real. Anthropic isn't a charity, and we all kind of knew a reckoning was coming. And I actually respect the honesty in the email. They don't sugarcoat it. They explain why. System capacity, fairness, policy violations, all the usual suspects. And they're upfront that they might adjust these limits as they learn more, which for me feels way better than getting randomly cut off mid-project with no warning. But yeah, it stings. Especially if you're a solo dev who's built your entire workflow on the old rules. There's a kind of loss of innocence here. The sense that for a while, you could just build and not worry about usage or budgets or invisible ceilings. That's gone now. I think what bothers me most is the uncertainty. Right now they say less than 5% of users will even notice. But what if your workflow is that outlier? What if you're building something a little bit weird or you're trying to ship a big feature and suddenly hit a wall? You can plan, but you can't predict everything. And that's a little scary. On the other hand, there's something to be said for healthy constraints. I remember when cloud hosting moved from unlimited everything to pay as you go. It was rough, but it also made us better builders. We learned to optimize, to respect resources, to code more thoughtfully. Maybe this will have the same effect on our AI workflows. Personally, this is going to change how I approach Claude. No more treating it like a bottomless pit for ideas, code, and drafts. I'll start to be a little more thoughtful. Break up sessions, make sure I'm not wasting tokens on half-baked prompts, maybe even batch my questions instead of peppering Claude all day with every thought that pops into my head. It's weird, because on one level, I feel like I'm being forced to be a little more professional about my AI usage. Instead of just opening Claude as a scratch pad, I'll plan my sessions like meetings. Come prepared, know what I want, keep it focused, wrap up when I'm done. In a strange way, that might actually help me build faster and cleaner. Less AI doom scrolling, more targeted collaboration. I'll also start to diversify my tool set again. Maybe some weeks I'll lean harder on Cursor or on GPT, or even go back to good old Stack Overflow and documentation. Maybe this is the nudge I needed to not get too comfortable in any one AI stack. And honestly, I'll probably stick to Max for now because I know my own patterns. I'll always push right up against the limits, and I'd rather have some headroom than hit a hard wall in the middle of a project. I want to end with the big picture because I think this is where most of us land after a big change like this. AI has grown up. It's not the Wild West anymore. There are rules and prices and boundaries. We're not going to get infinite, always-on, ultra-fast AI for $20 a month. And that's okay. It means the tools are maturing. It means Anthropic is investing in reliability, and we can expect fewer random outages or system slowdowns. It means we, as solo devs, are being treated like real users, not just a lucky afterthought riding the VC subsidy wave. But it's also a wake-up call. The build anything, use anything, never think about cost era is over. We have to budget for AI now, just like we budget for hosting, for design tools, for coffee and indie app subscriptions. It's a cost of doing business. And for most of us, it's worth it because the time, energy, and creativity we get back from these tools is still way more valuable than what we pay each month. If anything, I hope this helps us all be a little more mindful about how we build, about what tools we rely on, and about the value of our own time and attention. Maybe we'll start to see more indie-friendly pricing, more transparency, more thoughtful usage patterns, or maybe we'll all just learn to get really good at squeezing the most out of every session. So if you're feeling anxious or frustrated or just a little nostalgic for the old days, you're not alone. We're all figuring this out in real time. The ground keeps shifting, but the core truth hasn't changed. If you're building something you care about, if you're learning, if you're shipping, the tools are still there. The limits are just another constraint, not a reason to stop. Take a breath, review your plan, maybe tweak your workflow, but don't stop building. There's still so much you can do. If you have thoughts on this, or you're hitting those new limits already, let me know. DM me, drop a comment, whatever works. We're all in this together, even if we're building solo. Thanks for hanging out for this honest, slightly rambling chat about the new Claude changes. I'll be back soon with more devlogs, more experiments, and more honest takes about what it's like to be an indie dev in this wild AI-powered world. Until then, keep crafting, stay curious, and don't let the new rules kill your spark. Peace.